I think about the we've been in the same house now close to 40 years, and the swimming pool was your 1960s vintage kidney shape.
Yeah.
You've seen a million, of them, diving board.
Yeah.
So we raised our kids in it.
Yeah.
We've been raising our grandkids in it. And now about the only people that get in that pool right now are my dogs.
Yeah. Or if you're doing some yard work someplace, cool off.
Yeah, right. So the purpose of the pool, we've seen it evolve just in the time we've been at the house.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, pools used to be cookie cutters. So the same thing on almost everybody's yard. They either want a rectangular pool or a kidney-shaped pool. And most of them are all divers. But, you know, people have come to figure out a diving pool is fun and all, but it's not as useful as a play pool. A shallow pool.
Yeah.
You know, you want to be able to float around in the pool, relax, and the lifestyle's changed. You know, you want someplace to sit, you want someplace to enjoy the water, someplace to cool off, someplace to entertain, talk to people, and, you know, that's changed the design of swimming pools. They've come a long ways. You know, we put a lot of benches and seats and things like that in swimming pools now, where it used to be a diving board, one bench to get out.
Three steps in,
and that was it.
Yeah, and there was really no place just to recline with your spouse, your family, your kids. And I mean, you could sit in I don't know what, 80-degree water, 70-degree water, and be 120 outside.
Yeah.
You'd have a place to kind of visit right there.
Yep, and that's the thing about Arizona. You know, water's getting warm right now. Most people's pools are close to 90 degrees or a little higher.
That's about perfect for
me. Yeah, me too.
Once I've thought through how I want to use the pool, and I've pictured my next pool, I really have. But once I've pictured that next pool, I bring you out there. What are the things you're going to be looking at? I liked your idea of, hey, let's master plan this.
Yeah.
In the grand scheme of things.
Right.
Let's just not dig a hole right here without thinking through everything.
Yeah, and that's I come out. My first consultation is a conversation. You know, we talk about how the customer's going to use the yard. You know, the pool should be the first thing built, typically, just because of space, the space that it takes up. But
and equipment access as well. Oh. You know, who wants to have a nice landscape and then let's add a pool now? Well, all the heavy equipment coming in and all the dirt that's got to get trucked in and out of there. Tear up a
The bigger piece of machinery I can get into, the better. You know,
the faster, the cheaper.
The faster, the less expensive, and the less probability that we're going to have to bring in another piece of equipment to break up soil or caliche or rock or things like that. So the bigger piece of equipment I can get into, the better. But you know, you really need to think about the pool's going to go here. Okay, I want a Ramada. I want, you know, maybe I'm going to build a RV garage, or maybe I'm gonna, you know, do these things down the road.
That outdoor kitchen.
Yeah.
Gazebo, so let's pergola.
Yeah. Let's do the infrastructure that's correct. You know, more than likely I'm gonna have to pull a sub panel. So make sure I get plenty of power there for my future use, not just for the swimming pool.
Rosie on the house, every Arizona homeowner's best friend.